pastors that I know that I love, and they are trying to mix together Jesus and Karl Marx like this.
他说我有非常爱的牧师，我很熟悉的牧师。那么呢，他们现在想做的一件事情，就是把耶稣再加上马克思，在他们教会。
I know them personally.
我个人是认识这位牧师。
And the number one idolatry in the world today is the worldview that we call naturalism.
在今天全世界影响最大、这个对人类影响最大的这个哲学思想是自然主义的思想。
And naturalism says that very much like the Epicureans and Stoics, that only the universe exists and there is no transcendent God.
这个自然主义的哲学就像当年保罗在雅典所争辩的那样，就是这些人只相信有看得见的宇宙自然和这个地球，他们不相信在这个之外有上帝的存在。
And so these pastors will use Bible words, but their thinking is based on the idea that God does not exist.
这些的牧师呢，他们用圣经上的话，但是他们并不相信在看得见的这一个这一个世界之外还有神。
So if we take a look at Acts chapter 20,
here's a question. How could a pastor quoting a Bible verse and don't believe God exists? Is that possible?
Yes.
我刚才的问题就是说，怎么有这个可能？一个牧师引用圣经却不相信神的存在？他说是，就是有这样的牧师。It's one of the million?
Oh, no. It's running rampant in America today.
我问他是不是百万分之一，他说不是，很多的牧师都是这样的。
Yeah, and the first time that this occurred in history was in Europe, and that's what led to World War II.
他说第一次在基督教教会里面出现这样的事情，就是虽然是基督教的牧师，也讲圣经，但是不相信神的存在，这样的一个思潮就是一个重要的影响，产生了第二次世界大战。
Yeah. And so when we take a look at Acts chapter 20, the apostle Paul, he is at Miletus, and he calls for the Ephesian elders, the elders from Ephesus, to come and meet him in Miletus, and He tells those pastors that some of you are going to fall away and take the flock with you. He warns them.
所以当保罗在使徒行传二十章里面对一些长老在说话的时候，他说你们有些人会要把一些的人从教会里面带走，你们要谨慎。
And the letter to Colossae is addressed to the church at Colossae. So this letter is addressed to Christians, and he warns them, do not be taken captive by the empty and deceitful philosophy.
所以哥罗西书这里是说到是对基督徒说的，让他们要小心，要谨慎，不要被这个世上的理学小学所掳去。
Let me give an example from the Old Testament. Okay, Elijah on Mount Carmel. Every pastor here has read Elijah on Mount Carmel.
我跟大家讲一个例子，大家都熟悉的以利亚。
Okay, and so we all know the historical account. There's Elijah, and then there's the 450 prophets of Baal.
那 okay, 大家都知道在这个以利亚的这样的一个 见证神奇般的见证里面，一边是以利亚一个人，一边是四百位这个巴利的先知。
Okay, and so there's the 450 prophets of Baal. They build their altar. They put the cow on the altar, and they call on Baal to light the cow on fire, and Baal does not show.
那450位个先知，他们就筑坛，他们就献祭物，他们就向巴利祷告，求巴利的神降火下来焚烧这个祭物。
Yeah, and so what happens is that when they're done, Elijah steps up, he prays, he builds the altar, puts the cow on the altar, water, more water, more water, more water, okay? And then he stands back and he prays to God, and God shows up with the fire.
所以现在就是轮到这个以利亚来见证神，他也筑坛他也献祭物，然后有很多的以色列民来这个把水浇灌在上面很多很多的水浇灌在上面，然后以利亚就向神祷告，结果神的震怒就显现，就从天上降火下来。
And so we're very impressed with that story. That's a very dramatic story.
这个故事大家都知道，而且大家都非常的这个熟悉。
And we get so caught up with the fire coming down that we forget the basic element of that story.
很多人都被这个神迹所吸引，所震撼，但是很多人都忽略了这个故事最重要的一个关键的环节。
And that is that the 450 prophets of Baal, they were Jewish men who thought that they could take Jehovah and Baal and put them together.
很多人都不知道450个巴利的先知，他们其实是犹太人，他们想做的一件事情就是把耶和华的名和巴利的名来加在一起，合在一起。
They in their head and in their heart where they decide and how they lived out in their bodies, they worshipped God and they worshipped Baal, and God said, no way, only me.
所以这个就是一个实例，怎么会在今天的美国教会又有牧师讲解圣经，同时又把马克思主义加进来，又不相信神的存在，在以利亚的这个见证这个故事的里面就看得出来，就完全看得出来，这是人类历史上一直存在的一个事情，就是450个先知其实都是犹太人，但是他们所做的就是一边敬拜耶和华上帝，一边他又敬拜巴利，但是耶和华上帝不允许这样的事情发生。
So when we look at Gospel of John chapter 1, we learn that it's Jesus who spoke and the universe comes into being.
那我们知道在约翰福音第一章里面是讲到这个太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神，这个就是当上帝的话出来的时候，上帝的道出来的时候，这个宇宙就被创造了。
Baal did not make the universe.
The 巴利并没有创造宇宙。
Epicurus did not make the universe.
这些的雅典的这些的哲学并没有创造宇宙。
Stoics did not make the universe.
这些的雅典的人并没有创造宇宙。
Karl Marx did not make the universe.
马克思并没有创造宇宙。
Jesus and Jesus alone with the Father and the Spirit created the universe.
圣父、圣子、圣灵三位一体的神创造了这个宇宙。
And so Christians today, they want to take Jesus plus Marx to bring it together. They're doing the same thing that Baal and Yahweh together. God will not tolerate being side by side with the idea made in the human mind.
所以今天在全世界的教会， 包括或者是特别美国的教会一个最重要的一个现象一个罪，就是耶稣加其他的东西。
The first commandment is about loving the Lord our God with our whole heart and no other God beside him.
所以今天的教会的问题就是耶稣加其他的东西。那这是跟当年这个以利亚来跟这个巴利来对峙的时候，那巴利也是想把耶和华加上其他的东西。所以圣经里面教导我们是要尽心尽力尽意独一的来敬畏耶和华。
When we rebel against God, we're saying that we can make the final decision, and we are practicing idolatry when we make ourselves our own God.
所以当人犯罪的时候，他是用自己的思想意念自己的意志来自己来在自己的心思意念里面来创造一个这样的一个世界观。
The very, very first commandment is a testimony that every human being has at some point has had a passion to deny God and to worship something other than God.
所以圣经里面从最开始一直到今天指出来的就是人总想在神之外来创造一个他自己的一个敬拜的对象。
It doesn't matter if the humans are living in the days of Elijah and they worship Baal and they want to bring Baal together with Jehovah, or whether it's in our day where we have Christians that want to take Marx and Jesus and bring them together and that they believe that that's okay with God and it's not okay with God.
所以在以利亚的时代和今天的这个时代所发生的事情都是一样，就是在神的名之外要加上一个东西，但是耶和华神是绝对不允许这样的事情发生的。
So when we are proclaiming Jesus to a non-believer, their number one sin is not their lying, it's not their stealing, it's not their adultery. Their number one sin is that they have made themselves the final authority in their life and they are playing God in their life.
所以当我们跟别人传福音的时候，其实我们要看清楚的不是他们的偷窃，不是他们的说谎，不是他们的这个罪或者那个罪，我们要看清楚最重要的就是他们自己在心里面来这个自己做主自己做王自己里面有一个这样的一个偶像在崇拜。